And somebody said, yeah. Where my ladies?
Yeah, that was too good. Never mind.
Fellas, I ain't gonna give you a shout out. That was too cool right there. How many of y'all know at the basement, we're going to tell you true life is this, and we'd like to say it for you first time visitors, those who might be watching, or say, man, you don't even know what this thing's about, you just showed up, you don't even know how you got here, man. As you was walking down the road, somebody picked you up and said, come on, check this out. We would like for you to know, if it's your first time, or you're watching somewhere around the world, here at the basement, we are not perfect, we are just.
Forgiven.
We are just.
Forgiven.
Or another way you can say it is, God, can we start again? And he'll always say, always. So I'm going to say that one more time. I want to hear you say it loud. God, can we always, can we start again?
Always.
Yes, we can. How many of y'all know, though, that this very month, it's actually for a lot of people, and those of you who are had like a prom occasion, this month has been celebrated around the country and in our state for prom. Do I have any prom fans in Heezy? All right, for those of you who hadn't been to prom in a while, and I can look at the crowd and I can tell some of you ain't been there in a while. We want to take you back. We want to get on a bus with you, and we want to see what kind of memory lane you've been on. Or if you ain't got to prom yet, say some of you in middle school or high school, and you're on the way, because prom is a big deal. How many know everybody marks their life by something? Some people go, man, I can't wait to get to high school. Man, I can't wait to drive a car. Man, I can't wait till I get to college. Man, I can't wait for prom. I can't wait till the one I'm there. I'll tell you something. Can be a big deal. So I'm going to take you on memory lane for a second. We're going to go into a prom party ourselves. And this is the only rule. You can dance if you want to dance. But you can only dance if you know the song.
Okay.
But you can dance however you want to dance. So we're at prom, right? And you walk in, there's always that one song. You
funky, funky. Everybody clap your hands.
Song.
I know some of y'all though, y'all remember the 90s. How many of y'all remember the 90s kind of prom? This song used to give me chills. I caught it at the beginning of the song. I was like, I love anybody, but I love you. I love you. You want to dance? Hold it, DJ. And there used to be this part of the song where her mouth would just, I don't even know what it would do to me. It'd be like, and she'd be like, hey! Did that dude just come out of prison or what? That was my role. I was like, oh God, what happened? The biggest girl I've ever seen. I like him strong. Boy, she's strong. But I'm going to say something. Some of you might not agree with this, and that's cool. How many know the eyes in heaven sees us all as one color? We'll say that again. How many know that heaven sees us all as one color? But before you shout too loud, that don't mean we all dance the same.
Let's do that.
I grew up in an all-black community, so I know, man, white folks and black folks just dance different. White folks got the two-step. Like, so stiff. We don't even know what we're doing. Like, yeah, right here. Oh, you just stepped on my shoe. You hurt my feet. Let me leave. Come on, let me leave. We look like idiots. Let's just quit. No, friend, I used to walk over at parties, man. The right folk knew how to party. They put their hands up on the hip. Hold that right there. Just a difference. Not saying you have to agree, I'm just saying it's a difference. But how many know we're all the same? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But I'll never forget, man, I went from 8th grade, 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, and 12th grade. I was actually invited to go to prom. And the last year was the worst, but it was supposed to be the best, and it's just the truth. How many of you have ever had one of those moments where you've been like, God, if you can get me out of this, I'll serve you for the rest of my life. So some of y'all know what I'm talking about. You said somewhere along the lines, like, can we start over again? But you said somewhere along the lines, God, if you just get me out of this, or here, or out of this situation, I will serve you to the day I die. And you wake up and you'll never do it. I mean, I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Boy, my mama came to me my 12th grade year. The worst thing she could have ever told me. She said, guess what? I said, what's that? She said, you know, when you're prom, we really want to be here. And, we're not going to be able to be here because we got to go visit family. We want to take some photos. And I was like, you going to visit who? She said, family. I was like, family, I guess y'all going to leave the state? And she's like, yeah, we're going to leave the state. And something in my mind said, party. How many know, though, you can tell somebody something and the whole world will know it within 5 or 10 seconds? You ever trusted somebody before somebody in your life? Hey, man, don't tell anybody this. And man, people walking down the hallways, man, I heard you. You're like, man, hope I'll never tell them nothing important. I'm going to tell you this, man, I showed up at my house, smelled like a marijuana factory. People already smoking downstairs, pot was in the place. It was cocaine on my parents. My mom and dad asked me, I mean, they specifically said, nobody's allowed at this house. Because everybody found out at my school, and at the same time, it was everybody's prom. Everybody was having prom the same weekend. Man, I had people from Hoover, Vestavia. Believe it or not, people from Hoover and Vestavia do come to Roebuck. I'm going to say that one more time. Believe it or not, y'all do come over there. We do have Payless. Looking at some of your shoes, I can tell.
No, we got the shoe department.
And so, man, everybody comes, and I'm having a ball. Man, it's going to be the gym. I get there, and it's this massive disaster. The police are called. Man, I don't know if you've ever had the police call on you, but in my lifetime, I have many some times. And this is one of them times, and I'm just going to tell you how it happened. They walked into my house because of the drug paraphernalia, the alcohol, and no parental guidance at all. He said, who's the owner of this house? I was like, him.
Yeah.